A few years ago, we actually did an international study with 17 countries and some 900 programs across those countries, trying to look at how teacher preparation was done, both for middle school teachers and for elementary or primary school teachers. And so we studied these teachers. We found out what they took while they were in their preparation. And in the very end of their preparation, we actually tested them on their mathematics knowledge. Well, one of the things that we were able to do with these data is we actually could look at those top 39 programs and to look at what the requirements were. Now, these programs were the ones that had the highest, they were the top 10% in terms of performance on that test we gave them. Of those, looking at those 39, we came to understand that there was virtually all of those future teachers in those 39 programs took a set of 9 courses. 6 university-level mathematics courses, 2 courses that dealt with the pedagogy of teaching mathematics, and a 3rd course which deals with school mathematics. We found that only a third of them, roughly, about 31%, actually met the international benchmark in their preparation. So that's not that encouraging, even though we have the some programs that do this. We have a lot of programs that are not doing this, and correspondingly, then only about a third of our teachers reaching that international benchmark. We actually were able to follow up 2 years after they've been out from their teacher preparation. They were teaching mathematics in various schools around the country. We followed up with them and asked them a question, which was, how confident do you believe you are academically to be able to teach a list of topics? And we found there was a very strong relationship between not just what they knew as demonstrated by their score on that test when they left teacher preparation, but also the coursework they took, so that those that had more coursework consistent with the international benchmark not only had an impact on their knowledge and the test, but it also impacted on their confidence in terms of their teaching. So we are having our teacher preparation prepare teachers with a level of mathematics knowledge that varies from the very top to developing countries. So that's striking, that the bottom 25% of the institutions are producing over 60% of our future teachers. So the story, I think, that's really important for the lower middle school teacher preparation is what you teach, what expectations you have for those teachers while they're studying, how much mathematics that's required, how much of pedagogy is required. That's what makes a difference. We now know that that is related not only to their knowledge that they come out and they demonstrate for us on a test, but also to the degree of confidence that they have in the teaching of those topics some 2 years out. That's a very important finding, I think, and suggests that what we need is to think about standards for teacher preparation. We have some of the best programs in the world, but the students of those or ones that are comparable, at least in some sense, go to the better schools and to the higher SES schools. And those institutions who have the worst track record essentially more predominantly go to our low SES schools, our high poverty schools. And that seems to be certainly something that would be related to concerns about the achievement gap and whether the system is equitable in providing equal opportunities for all students. This would suggest this only exacerbates the differences we know that exist in curriculum as well.